abacus classes.
Good evening students, welcome back. How are you? I hope you are in the best of your health. Welcome to the abacus classes. I am your abacus teacher, Miss Garima Singh. So students, our today's topic is multiplication with 7. But before starting our today's topic, I want to tell you something about abacus tool. This abacus tool is not new for you. You have already seen it and you are using also this tool in your sums. So kids, I want to tell you that this is the mid rod of the abacus tool. The middle rod. And this rod is called units rod, or you can say it ones rod. You have learnt in maths ones, tens, hundred. Many a times in your maths you have learnt. So this is also, this is ones, this is tens, and this is hundreds rod. See, ones rod, tens rod, hundreds rod. Ones rod, this first one, tens rod, this second one, and hundreds rod, this third one. So kids, this abacus tool we always use in our sums. It makes your sums very easy. You can easily do your multiplication sums with the use of abacus tool. But one thing, you should know how to use it. So kids, please make sure that you have the abacus tool with you. Students, you will only get it when you will do with me. The most easiest and the best method is just play my video and do with me. If you will do 2 to 3 sums with me, then very, very easily you can do other sums with the help of this tool. So I'm sure that all have taken their abacus tools in their hands. Very nice. Sabne apna abacus tool apne paas rakh liya hai. Very good. Ab aap mere saath video ko dekhte hue abacus ko kariye. By this you can easily learn it. Aap aisa karenge to aap easily use learn kar sakte hain. So students, in my previous video, hamari purani video mein, we have learnt multiplication with 6. And in that, I have also told you small friends. Maine aapko small friends formula bhi sikhaya tha. I think you remember, those who have seen my previous video. This is the starting of our today's topic. Ye hamara starting hai hamare today's topic ka. So today, we will do normal sums in which small friends are not being used. Hum wo sums karenge aaj multiplication with 7 mein, jisme small friends ka use nahi hota hai. Without using any small friend, you can do your sums. But some sums are there, kuch sums aise hote hai, in which you have to use small friends. That topic we will take in our next video. So students, stay tuned to learn more. So we will start our topic with the first sum. My first sum is 38 into 7. Now what you have to do? See, the students who are not getting previous sums or the other sums, just focus on today's video. If you will get this, you can do other sums like that. First of all, multiply the first digit with 7. अपनी पहली डिजिट को 7 से मल्टीप्लाई करिए. 3 into 7. 7 threes are 21. See, this is dodging. I have told you, if you have to count 7 nines are, if you have to count 7 eights are, so you don't have to count the table from 1. Like 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, 7 threes are 21. It's wrong. The dodging means that you know the table directly. If I ask 7 8s are, so directly you will say 56. If I say 7 9s are, so directly you will say 63. You don't have to count the table from 1. This is called dodging. So for doing the sums, you should learn dodging. Now 21. Now your first digit goes in tens rod and the second digit goes in hundreds rod. Students, this you have to learn. Please make sure in your mind that when you multiply the first digit with 7, the first number go in tens rod and the second hundreds rod. Means you start your calculation from hundreds rod. In my previous videos also, I have told you that we start our calculation from hundreds rod. So, this is our number. The first number is 2 and 2 will go in hundreds rod. So, 2 means you have to add 2. So, 2 beads up. See, it is taking time because I am rubbing the beads and I am taking them up. You have the abacus tool with you. You can do it directly. So, 2. Now, this we have done. Now the 1 in tens rod. 1 means you have to add 1. Done. See 1, 2 and 1. 21. 2 in hundreds rod and 1 in tens rod. Nice. Fine. Now you will multiply your next number with 7. Eight sevens are or seven eights are 56. Now your this number will go in tens rod and this will go in ones rod. You can say ones, you can say units, anything. Ones rod or units rod, anything you can write. O or U. You can write O or you can write U. So this 10 in tens rod, 5. This is tens rod. So 5 means 5 beat down. When you have to add 5, you put the 5 beat down. See, down I have done. Now you have to add 6 in units rod or ones rod. 6 means 5 and 1 from down, 6. So, what is your answer? Count. First of all, you have started your calculation from hundreds rod. So, start from 100. See, 1, 2. 2 in 100. Now, in tens rod, see, 5, 5, 6. And in ones rod, 5, 6. So this is your answer. Students, you can do it very fast. If you will do it in abacus tool. I am writing all this. You don't have to write this. Just 7 threes are 21. Put 21 in abacus tool. Then 7 eights are 56. Put 56 in abacus tool. And your answer is there. I am writing this to make you explain how you have to do in your abacus tool. So kids, let's move to our next sum. Set your abacus, students. As you are doing with me, so I think you all are having abacus tool with you. Very good. Set your abacus again. Up beads, up, lower beads, down. When you will do 2 to 3 sums with me, you can easily do these sums with the help of abacus tool. So our next sum, students, 69 into 7. Now, what is our strategy? First of all, multiply the first digit with 7. Students, you don't have to do this calculation. You only put your abacus tool in front of you. As the number is coming, just put the number in abacus tool. So, 6 into 7. 7 6 are 42. So your this number will go in 100 slot and this number will go in 10 slot because you start your calculation from 100 slot. So 100 slot then 10 slot. Now 100 slot. 4 you have to add in 100 slot. 4 means you have to put 4 beads up. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Students, in your abacus tool, in 100 slot means in 3rd rod put the 4 bead up. Okay, fine. All have done. Very nice. Now put 2 in 10 slot. 2, you have to add. Add means put the beads up. So 1, 2. See, 2. You have put the beads up. 2 is added. Now multiply the next digit with 7. Seven nines are 63. Now this will go in tens rod and this will go in ones rod, or you can say units rod, anything. Don't get confused. Ones rod or units rod, anything you can call it. So first of all you will add 6 in tens rod. See, T is written tens rod. See, mid one is tens rod, so 6 you have to add. 6 means this 5 and 1 from down, 6. Have you done? What you have to do? You have to put the 5 B down and 1 B up. 5 B down and 1 B up. This is 5, 6. Now you have to add 3. So 3 beads up in 1's rod. 1, 2, 3. In 1's rod, put 3 bead up. So 1, 2, 3. Now your question is done. Just put the answer here. See, in this rod, 100's rod, what is your answer? See, all the 4 beads are up. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Then in this C, 5 bead is down. This means it is added. So we will count it. 5, 6, 7, 8. And in this C, 1, 2, 3. So this is your answer. So we will move to our next sum. Just set your abacus till then. Upper beads up and lower beads down. Students, in your class 3rd, 4th, you have done abacus. So, you know how to add 5 bead. You know how to add this 1, 2, 3 bead. So, it will be very easy for you. The students who are doing the sums direct, just try with abacus tool. Now, over next sum. Yes, students. First of all, you know, multiply the first number with 7. So 1 into 7 is 7. Now students, in my previous videos also, in multiplication with 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, I have told you that whenever you multiply the first digit and it comes a single digit, so you apply zero rule. Remember kids? Very nice. What is zero rule? Zero rule means that whenever you get a single digit in the first multiplication, means when you multiply the first number and you get a single digit. See, when I will multiply this with 7, if I will get a single digit, then zero rule you will not apply. Means in the second multiplication, if it comes a single digit, then you will not apply the zero rule. Agar दूसरी बार मल्टीप्लीकेशन में सिंगल डिजिट आता है, सिंगल डिजिट मीन्स वन डिजिट, लाइक दिस 7, 8 या फिर 9, सो यू विल नॉट यूज जीरो रूल. आप जीरो रूल यूज नहीं करेंगे. लेकिन अगर फर्स्ट डिजिट को मल्टीप्लाई करने पे सिंगल डिजिट आता है तो आप उस पे जीरो रूल अप्लाई करेंगे. you will use zero rule. Now what is zero rule? Zero rule means you will apply zero in front of your number. आप अपने नंबर के आगे एक जीरो लगा देंगे. This is zero rule. Understand kids? Very nice. Now your number becomes 07. अब आपका नंबर 07 बन चुका है. Now you will, the first number will go in hundreds rod and the second will go in tens rod. The same as you do, first in hundred, then in tens. So zero in hundred. Now zero means nothing. And seven in tens. Seven. So put seven. In tens rod means middle rod. See, for seven we will use five. Five. Six. Seven. So kids, what I have done? I have put five beads down and two beads up. मैंने five beads को नीचे किया and two beads को ऊपर किया. So five, six, seven. Done kids, in your abacus tool, very nice. Now 7 you have added. Now this is complete. Now multiply this 4 with 7. Seven fours are 28. Now put this in tens rod and this in ones rod. So 2 in tens rod. 2 in tens rod means 2 beads up. 2 beads up in tens rod and 8 in ones rod. 8 means we will use 5. 5, 6, 7, 8. See, 5 I have put down and 3 I have put up. So 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 we have added. Now we will go for our answer. See, in hundreds rod there is nothing. Nothing we have added. So nothing means 0. Then in tens rod we have added, see, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And in this ones rod we have added 5, 6, 7, 8. So your answer is 98. Students, again I am repeating, reminding you that I am doing all the calculations by writing and I am also doing your this calculation in abacus tool by rubbing and putting the beads up. You can do it very fast when you will do in abacus tool, and all this multiplication you will do in your mind. So kids, do you get something kids? See, in our today's sum we have not got any question in which the bead is not there. Like we have to add 2 and the bead is not there. That type of sums we are not getting today. This means that our today's sums are not based on small friends formula. Hamara aaj ka topic small friend formula pe based nahi hai. It is the normal multiplication sums of multiplication with 7. So you don't have to use the small friends in it, because you use the small friends only when there is lack of beads. Jab beads nahi hote hain, aap tabhi small friends ka use karte hain. In these questions, there is no lack of beads. We can easily add them. That's why we are not using any small friends. That small friend topic we will take in our next video. So kids, now our last sum. Kids, set your abacus, upper beads up and lower beads down, and it is our last sum, so just concentrate. Set your abacus, upper beads up, lower beads down, and it is our last sum. 71 into 7. This sum we will do directly. Directly means you will calculate the sum in your mind. Let's do. Now first of all multiply the first number with 7. 7 sevens are 49. As you know, this will go in hundreds rod and this will go in tens rod. So let's do. Hundreds rod add 4 1, 2, 3, 4. Now at 9 and 10th rod, so use 5, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. See, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. For adding 4, what I have done? 4 be up in 100th rod. For adding 9, what we have done? 9 in 10th rod we have to add. So 5 beads I have put down and 4 beads I have put up. Now multiply the next digit with 7. So 1 7's are 7. And this is a single digit. So it will go in the last rod, which is 1's rod. 7. So 7 here. See, 5 we will use. Put the 5 bead down and 2 beads up. Five bead down, two bead up for 7. So 5, 6, 7. Now your answer is there. See, in hundreds rod how much? See, 1, 2, 3, 4. In tens rod 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And in this last ones rod or units rod 5, 6, 7. So this is your answer. See, without putting the lines, we have done this sum. First of all, we have multiplied the first digit with 7. Then we have multiplied the second digit with 7. Students, with this video, I have given you one practice PDF. I hope, kids, you have watched my previous video and done the previous PDF in your Abacus notebook. Abacus Fair notebook. And kids, with my video, there is always one message. In that message, my contact number is there. Whenever you get any problem regarding this tool, regarding any sum, regarding the topic, you can call in that number for solving your queries. And with this video also, I have given you one practice PDF. Kids, try to do that practice PDF by using Abacus tool in your Abacus Fair notebook. So kids, I hope you like my today's video and stay tuned to learn more with me. Thank you.
Practice the sums at home. Like and subscribe the video. Thank you.